a centralized settings variable to control all of the different settings for your Google Analytics tag can make it much faster and simpler to get up and running with Google Analytics using Google Tag Manager. Let us show you how easy it is to create one.
Great. So from within your Google Tag Manager container, you'll first want to go to your variables screen. And we're going to create a new user-defined variable for our Google Analytics settings. It's worth noting that you can create this variable in line while you're setting up your Google Analytics tags, but if you do want to set it up ahead of time, you can do it from this variable screen, as we'll show you now. So I'll click to create a new user-defined variable, click into the variable configuration, and we will find our Google Analytics settings variable type. Now this settings variable will act as the central place for all of the settings we need for our various Google Analytics tags, from our page views to our events. So the first thing we'll do is we'll enter in our tracking ID. By default, the cookie domain is set to auto, and we recommend that you keep this as is unless you have special cross-domain settings that you want to absorb here, which you can find more info about in our developer documentation. All of the additional settings that you might be familiar with, such as fields to set, custom dimensions, custom metrics, and so on, can be found under the More Settings menu. So within fields to set, as an example here, if I wanted to use the allow linker parameter for cross-domain tracking, I would enter in allow linker with a value of true. For custom dimensions, I can proceed to add custom dimensions with the relevant index values, such as 1, with a value of sports for page type. If I wanted to, of course, I can also pull in additional values for these custom dimensions and metrics directly from other variables inside of Google Tag Manager, which I can configure here.
And one of the benefits of this centralized settings variable and using this across multiple Google Analytics tags is if you do have an update to any of these things, for example, a custom dimension that you want to add sometime later, adding it in here will automatically add that to every tag that you're firing for Google Analytics.
Exactly. So this really is a central place to manage all of these settings. Now, once I've gone through and I've selected all of the settings that I want for the initial set of Google Analytics tags, all I have to do is save this and give it a name, and I will maybe say that this is my primary Google Analytics settings, and I'll save this. It's worth noting that you can create multiple sets of Google Analytics settings. So if I had different sites that I was managing tagging across, or if I had a development environment with different sets of custom dimensions and metrics or a different property ID, I could handle that with a different Google Analytics settings variable. And we'll be able to use this settings variable later as we set up more Google Analytics tags.